I want to turn to the Trump side of the ledger and talk about the fact that some figures in Donald Trump's orbit are concerned about someone who's been traveling with him lately. I'm talking about Laura Loomer, a far-right conspiracy theorist. She's called herself pro-white nationalism and a proud Islamophobe. These are things that this woman who is with Donald Trump has said. And yesterday, she was with Trump at 9/11 ceremonies in New York and Pennsylvania. This is someone who pushed a conspiracy that the attacks were an inside job with Donald Trump at Ground Zero, or at the areas in and around the 9/11 ceremonies. Loomer was also seen getting off Trump's plane in Philadelphia ahead of the debate, and some blame her for putting stories like the immigrants eating pets lie into his head. She's even too extreme for Marjorie Taylor Greene, who isn't exactly a poster child for political correctness. Greene responded to a racist post that Loomer put up about Kamala Harris. Greene wrote, "This is appalling and extremely racist. It does not represent who we are as Republicans or MAGA. This does not represent President Trump. This type of behavior should not be tolerated ever." Now, Trump aides have tried for years to keep Loomer away from him. Obviously, that is not working. Lou, what are you hearing from your sources about this?
There's a lot of concern that Trump is trying to sort of go back and recreate the 2016 narrative that he had, where he was sort of this upstart candidate, where he was saying things that were controversial, where he was bringing in people who were not part of the Republican establishment. He's trying to recreate that, but now he's bringing in people that are highly problematic, people that have these very noxious views about different Americans who embrace racist ideology. And so there are people who are trying to create the feeling that Trump has a professional organization, people like Chris LaCivita and Susie Wiles. But when you bring in someone like Laura Loomer, you blow that up, and it makes it very clear, as we saw in the debate stage, that Trump is not going to have a professional approach. He's going to go back to his instincts, which is to blow things up. And Laura Loomer is someone is helping with that.
And he's certainly not trying to get any independent voters or suburban moms when they see this kind of behavior. Look, when you have Marjorie Taylor Greene saying that something's bad, you should really pay attention, he's invigorating MAGA only. And I think that's a huge mistake, dog whistling to the racist crowd. I guess he's banking everything on simply turnout of MAGA. We all know that independents have a lot to do with, you know, evaluating and solving elections, but maybe he's thinking that this is going to be a win for him because he's just going to invigorate them so much.
Real quick.
I just think that this is a massive gatekeeping failure of the Trump campaign. I mean, covering the Trump administration, in every single meeting in the Oval Office, aides were jockeying to be the last person to leave the room to try to moderate whatever the president had heard during that meeting and try to have that final fingerprint on what he ended up saying or doing.
I am curious then, Pete, how things like Laura Loomer play, maybe, with these swing voters. Laura Loomer is a conservative activist, someone who has leaned into conspiracy theories that 9/11 was an inside job, among others, traveling with Donald Trump to New York for 9/11, you know, traveling with him around the debates and whatnot. And Marjorie Taylor Greene, what Laura Loomer has said recently online is so extreme that Marjorie Taylor Greene is speaking out. Let me read you sort of this tweet thread here. Marjorie Taylor Greene writes, "This is appalling and extremely racist. It does not represent who we are as Republicans or MAGA. This does not represent President Trump. This type of behavior should not be tolerated ever. Laura Loomer should take this down." What is she talking about? Well, Laura Loomer put out a tweet. I'm not going to read the whole thing because it's racist, fully on racist, but she says, "If Kamala Harris wins, the White House will smell like curry," among other things, Pete. So if Marjorie Taylor Greene is speaking out against you, what does that tell you who about the person you're taking on your plane in case of Donald Trump and Laura Loomer?
Well, you were kind in your description of Laura Loomer. She's a lunatic, and I don't think anyone should pay attention to anything she says. And it's troubling. It is troubling that the Republican nominee and a former president of the United States and potentially the next president holds her in such high regard. And the reason is because he feeds, or she feeds, his worst impulses. That's what he wants. He feeds off of that type of rhetoric and those types of conspiracy theories. And she is going to just keep giving him the red meat that he wants, and she'll remain in that inner circle, which is it's a problem. It's a troubling development. But I would just encourage folks to not pay attention to her, because 99.9% of what comes out of her mouth is completely insane.
She's getting a seat on Trump's plane, Anna.
Right. His wife isn't on the plane. His daughter isn't on the plane. But this kook is on the plane. And I think it should be incredibly concerning that potentially the next president of the United States is surrounded by racist conspiracy theorists. Listen, when Marjorie Taylor Greene is all of a sudden the voice of reason, we've got to, like, you know, call it a wake-up moment. And I do think we need to pay attention to it, because I'd like to know what role she's going to have in a future Trump administration. I'd like to know what kind of access she would have to the future, possibly, president of the United States. And by the way, I would tell Laura Loomer, I've been in Kamala Harris's house, and you know what it smells like? It smells like power. It smells like patriotism. It smells like equality. It smells like a woman who's broken glass ceilings.
Ana Navarro, Pete's seat. Appreciate you being with us this morning. Thank you very much.